Good morning, my dame. Good to hear. Where to?
Can I help you?
Yes. Yes?
But that's how it is. Life is what you make.
An outlander. Isn't this nice?
Please, I'm so hungry.
Yes?
A penny, madame. Please. Just one penny.
That's all you've got.
This is holy ground, Outlander. You don't belong here.
This...
Walk blessed. Oh, yes. Guess what? There is. Some people just don't get the meaning of the word reliability. Huh. It just doesn't make any sense. You're not from the Order, are you? Elia, the novice who was assigned to me, she's supposed to help me transcribe these Pyrian tomes the Grand Master is so obsessed about. But 2 days ago, she simply vanished in the Nobles' Quarter. I'd go look myself, yes, but I'm lucky if I get to breathe within all this work. Go find her, and tell her to get her bloody ass up here and help me. If you do that, it won't be to your disadvantage.
Now, if it isn't the prodigy, well... Yes, I know. She's already told me everything. But I'll leave the judgment to Aranthiel. He wants to talk to you anyway. Seems you've caught his interest. In the Emporium, the last building on the left side of the temple. Ah, yes, before I forget, my dame Lucy has left a token of gratitude for you. It's your choice. Do you want a book, an old map, or a bag of pennies? Very well. I'm sure we'll talk again later.
Yes.
Suspicion, Teela. And to send an entire division across the sea because of a suspicion is madness.
We need to find out who sent the And there he is. This Pegast said that they... After the Signet Stone, and if they succeed in getting hold of it next time, then the Black Guardian alone knows how to stop the cycle.
The cycle? Listening to you talk this makes me forget that all this fuss here is merely based on some bad dreams you and your Neremese friends had.
Oh, the threat is real. Deny it as much as you like, but deep inside, you feel it as much as I do.
Teela, this... You're a commander, and a commander doesn't care about feelings, but about facts. You have made this mistake before, Teelor, back then in Kira.
Natara,
and we all know...
The mission will happen. I'm sorry.
You have a visitor.
So, you are the prodigy everyone is talking about. I am Teelor Aranthiel, son of Lorius I and Grandmaster of the Order, and I'm honored to meet you. Yes. You are here because I believe that you are special. Humanity faces a threat that needs to be stopped, among other things, yes. I do not need to explain to you that the present situation on Veen is chaotic. The wars, the living dead, common people who are losing their minds, to name only the most obvious. What most people are not aware of is the connection between these events. You, however, have encountered it. I do. And I will explain everything to you. What it means, who we are, and what your part in all of this is. Come, follow me. So, you are the prodigy everyone is talking about. I am. Maybe you already know who I am. My entire life, I served the gods who ruled Vin. until their death 2 years ago. What you probably do not know is that the one responsible for their death was my son, Narazul Aranthial. He hated the Lightborn because he believed that they robbed mankind of their right to freedom, so he strived to overthrow them. He found followers, formed an army, and declared war on them, and thus on me, a servant of the Lightborn as well. It all ended in a battle 30 years ago, which Narazul won. He killed every single survivor except for me, and locked me in a dungeon on Nerim. I still do not know why he spared me. Good question. Because at the moment, stability is the highest good. The rulers of Kira and Kile both made the mistake to acknowledge the death of the gods to their people, and the civil wars that followed in their countries are evidence of the chaos that such a revelation entails. Enderal is the cradle of the Order of the Gods, the epitome of theocracy. I am sure you understand this. Maybe when all this is over, that will change. But for now, it is imperative that we deny all rumors of that kind. Yes, after more than 30 years, when the death of the gods made the magic around the prison disappear. And during my escape in the northern mountains of Nerim, I also had them for the first time, the dreams. I always saw the same glaring, terrible light, heard screaming, and I felt like I was burning up from the inside. And above all, like a veil, there was the knowledge of imminence. At first, of course, I dismissed these dreams as the delusion of a man close to death. So I concentrated on making it through the mountains somehow. 2 days after my escape, I was completely exhausted, and I would have died if a former acolyte of my son had not found me. Yes, but he did not recognize me, and brought me to their headquarters instead, an old monastery in the mountains. Maybe because they thought that the death of the Lightborn had made me insignificant. I do not know. Still, even after my recovery, the dreams continued. At first, I doubted my sanity. But after some time, I told the leader of the mages, Constantine, about them. And he said something that I'd never expected. I was not alone. He, as well as many others magically gifted on Vin, dreamed the same dreams. And the more we talked about the matter, the stronger our suspicion grew, which has now turned out to be the truth. The dreams, they come from the same place. They are a shared memory, a collective subconscious. Yes, I know that you can feel it too, and probably far more intense than we do. But like you back then, we were not able to make sense of the images. So we went looking for answers, the Pyreans. 3 things. First, there were many subconscious before us and before the Pyreans. Maybe hundreds, maybe thousands. Second, the history of each civilization unfolded and still unfolds according to a pattern. They emerge, they blossom, and at some point, at the apex of their existence, they simply disappear without any trace. And third, everything that has happened in the past years and which is still happening indicates that this disappearance lies ahead of us. We are part of an eternal loop, a cycle, and our cycle is approaching its end. Not identical. But one can split them up into episodes, which repeat themselves in the very same manner, into patterns. Yes, dramatically put, they're the envoys of the end. Yes, it does. At first, we considered it absurd, as probably you do at this moment. But there came a moment when we simply could not deny it anymore. We began to study the history of the Pyreans more intensely, and the parallels were extraordinary. In its early days, the Pyrean Empire was split up by a disaster, just like Vin was split up by the Starfall after the reign of the Eterna. Also, the Pyreans had a ruling caste who declared themselves gods after the catastrophe. The two castes of the Sun Priest. They, too, ruled until they were overthrown. And then, just like that, the Pyreans ceased to exist. They knew it was imminent, but they could not prevent it. They called this event the Cleansing. They tried, but they failed. Who knows why? Maybe they found out too late, or maybe they were too weak. That is the question we need to find an answer to. Even though there was war in the Pyrean Empire before its ruin, when the Cleansing happened, it was as if all living beings simply fell down and died. It is ghastly. Well, this is the reason why we need your help. Not only episodes of history recur within every cycle, characters do as well. Yes, the Pyreans call them the Emissaries. They emerge very shortly before the Cleansing occurs, like a law of nature, an answer to the Red Madness. And I am one of them, as are you. While I take on the role of the ruler, you take on the role of the prophetess. It's just a description. Call it what you will. But without doubt, it is the truth. Your story matches the descriptions perfectly. Yes. Former enemies or not, both sides have understood the magnitude of the threat. The magical knowledge of Narazul's former mages is vast, as is the power of the Holy Order. Even though not all of the Keepers agree, as you probably have already noted yourself. No. As I already said, the Emissaries simply appear at the beginning of the end, like pieces on a chessboard. We are determined by our skills. How and to what end we use them is our choice. I do not know. Firespark the Mage has told me your story. And even though your fate is tragic, unlike me, you were insignificant before your change. So maybe everyone can become an emissary, or we simply have not understood the pattern yet. On the one hand, your power. You carry the potential to master any skill within a fraction of the usual time needed. I assume you have already realized this. On the other hand, your ability to look into the past, and therefore into the future. Your visions are a window into the past. And as every cycle is based on the same events, it is a window into the future as well. You can feel the thread this world is woven with. And because of that, you can see things that have happened, and thus will happen again. This gift makes you indispensable to us, and it is why I want your help. That is the wrong question. The correct question is, what alternative do we have? To wait and die? Good. However, there's one more thing before the actual work begins. I want you to join our order, and to do so, you have to pass a test, a trial. It is. Whatever you think about our story, we are the only faction that is strong enough to oppose the cycle. If you want to be part of our mission, you need to have access to our knowledge and resources. There will be voices in the Order speaking against your admission, as they are speaking against the presence of the Neremese mages. Consider it an honor or a necessity. It is up to you. It is the trial the novices have to pass in order to be exalted to the role of a keeper. Only the best students of the Squalor are allowed admission. At this very moment, two novices are on their way to the testing grounds. I have informed them about your arrival. I have only a slight acquaintance with them. However, I know that they are both very talented and have been working hard toward the test. I had a hunch. Let us leave it at that. At the border to the Heartland, near the Whisper Wood, they will be waiting for you there. Take the Myrit, talk to Signet Master Bartar, and hand him this package. And then follow his orders. Ah, one more thing. It might be self-evident, but keep your knowledge about the death of the Lightborn to yourself. I do not believe you can do any real harm. But in the worst case, path-abiding people will consider you a heretic. After the cycle has been stopped, we will deliberate upon how we deal with the matter. If and how we tell our people about it. Now, leave. The sooner we can dispense with this formality, the better.
Well met. My Dame Deluna. And I... Well, seems the Grandmaster is crazy for you. So who am I to question his judgment?
This is holy ground, Outlander. You don't belong here.
So many and faces. Well,
it just didn't work, Master.
No matter how hard I try.
Yes, and there you have the problem.
Dark
you try.
The sun, light as the night.
Thank you. Yes? I'm sure I have just what you need. May his light guide you.
Quite the weapon you got there. I really hope you use it for the right cause.
Waka waka! She smiles into the
dark yes.
room and you puke! Oh whoa! Oh whoa! My heart is aflame!
It is over.
Yes. What are you doing?
Penny, madame. Please, just one penny.
An outlander. What are you doing in this part of the city?
What?
I don't know, somewhere else.
What? Did you say something? No, I'm perfectly fine. This is a grave, and I'm kneeling in front of it. I couldn't be better. I'm sorry. You didn't deserve that. My sister, Gadia. She... I don't know if you've heard about it, but there was this incident in the temple. The Red Madness. And you've heard about it. My sister... She was a novice, just as I am. And she... You know... She met this boy. He was only of the manufacturer's path, and neither our parents nor the Holy Order would have approved. She wanted to leave the city with him. Travel the lands. Just like in the bard songs. I called her a fool. I told her that it was our path to serve the Order, and that leaving here would be a sin. 3 days later, it happened. You say it as if it were far-fetched. But it is my fault. It is my fault she was in the lecture that day. No matter how I twist and turn it, this is how it is. Easy for you to say. Anyway, I should go back to the temple. Thank you for your words. Walk less.
Yes.
An outlander. What are you doing in this part of the city? Shouldn't you be, I don't know, some... Keep walking.
Potatoes, garlic, radish. Yeah. That should be it.
You're a foreigner, aren't you? I wish I'd have crossed the Red Sea once, or seen Kira, the Grand Bazaar. Oh, well.
Yeah.